Dozens of House lawmakers from Mindanao sign a manifesto rejecting the proposed secession of the region. 53 of the lower house's 60 congressmen from down south inked the manifesto, describing the proposal as a step in the wrong direction. The manifesto also called for the prosecution of those sowing disunity. Lanao del Norte First District Representative Muhammad Khalid Dimaporo now urging local executives in Mindanao to take a stand on the proposal of former President Rodrigo Duterte and former House Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez. Employees of Manila's International Airport are assured of options once the selected private operator assumes the management of the NAIA. Transportation Undersecretary Timothy Batan spoke Wednesday at a public hearing or briefing. He says the winning bid of San Miguel Corporation for the airport's rehabilitation includes a provision to offer jobs or retirement packages to its 12,000 personnel. Batan also says authorities remain open to having a dialogue with NAIA employees to address the remaining concerns. Government awarded to SMC last week the multi-billion peso privatization of the NAIA. It expects to rake in some 900 billion pesos in revenue from the project in the next 25 years.
Magkakaroon po ng offer at syempre po nasa atin pong mga kasamahan sa NAIA kung kanila pong tatanggapin yung offer na yon. Ang isa pa po ay kaakibat po ng offer na yan ay ang improved terms. So meron pong dagdag na sweldo kung kaya't atin pong inaasahan na ito po ay magiging acceptable sa atin pong mga empleyado sa NAIA.
President Marcos led Wednesday the inspection of the newly built access road connecting New Clark City to the Clark Airport in Pampanga. Now, the project expected to cut travel time between those two destinations from an hour to just 20 minutes. Marcos said the new road is a key component in boosting the Clark metropolis as an investment and tourism hub.
The Clark Metropolis has what it takes to be a mecca for tourists, a magnet of investments, and a market of goods and services. We must leverage these attributes into higher visitor traffic, attracting more investments that generate better jobs and spur economic activity. This road is much more than just an access road. It is part of our plan to propel Clark as an alternate growth area. It is a red carpet rolled out to those who will partake in all the best things that Clark can offer. It shows the path forward of building better more, so we will never lose our competitive advantage because unlocking the full potential of Clark is a continuing task.
The banking firm Standard Chartered believes the Philippine Central Bank will cut rates by 100 basis points this year. Its Asia economist Jonathan Ko points to easing inflation for his forecast.
I'm expecting 100 basis points of cuts from the BSP with 25 basis points starting in June and then 25 basis points each for the next three meetings of the year. And I think a few reasons why we are expecting the BSP to essentially cut rates. I think first, if you look at the month-on-month inflation trajectory, that is starting to show signs of disinflation. Even though the year-on-year inflation number may still be above 4% in Q2, for example. But I think if you look out ahead, forward-looking, you could see that inflation is probably going to fall below 4% sustainably. So that should give the BSP a bit more room to cut. The second thing is, with the Fed probably cutting, we are thinking starting in May, that should also put a cap in terms of dollar strength. And we do expect a weaker dollar trend to probably emerge a bit more sustainably once the Fed pivots and start cutting. Which means that dollar peso is probably going to be a bit less under pressure in terms of peso depreciation against the dollar, which should also allow the BSP to move because they don't have to worry about imported inflation, disanchoring inflation expectations because of a weak peso.
Ko also said he expects the U.S. Federal Reserve to cut rates in May.